Welcome to part four of our guide on assembling and painting Nagash. Now the end's in sight, there's really not that much more left to do. And in this part I'm going to show you how to paint all these remaining details. So things like the sword blade, the open book, the closed books, the gold, and also a couple of other odds and ends as well. Now once all that's done, I'm going to show you how to do the final assembly of the miniature. And that's the part I'm looking forward to the most, because I want to see the whole thing together. So let's get started. The first detail that I'm going to paint will be the sword blade, and it's important that with this it's completely black before you begin, so if there's any other colours on it, just neaten it up with a bad and black before you start. Now the colour you're going to need first will be Incubi Darkness, and I'm going to be applying this using two different brushes for two techniques. So I've got my fine detail brush here, and I've got a standard brush as well, and the fine detail brush is going to be used to apply an edge highlight. So I'm just going to get the paint ready, and then this is to go all the way around the edge of the blade. So you can use the side of your brush for this because the detail is very pronounced. So you're looking at just painting a line running all the way around the sides and also down the middle. And once again, you can use the side of your brush to get a nice neat line running all the way down. Now, once you've done this all the way around the blade, you also need to do some parts on these trails that are coming off them. So for that, switch over to your standard brush and just get the paint ready as well. And this is going to be applied more of a kind of a layer really. So once you're ready, you're looking to paint this on these trails. Now they have a line kind of down the middle of them. So what you need to do is just paint along that, but quite wide to either side of it like that. So what you're creating is almost kind of an arrowhead pointing inwards towards the middle of the blade. So just work around the whole sword now on both sides doing this, and then we can start to brighten it up. I've finished the base coat now, and also, I forgot to mention, but just down here at the base is a little skull, and I've completely gone over all of that as well. And now I'm going to start adding a bit more colour to it by using Cobalt Green. And this I'm going to be applying completely using my fine detail brush. So I'm just going to get the paint ready, again in the same way. But this time I'm going to be doing the edge highlight and the trails using this brush. So the edge highlight is going to be identical to what we've just done before. So working around the whole edge of the blade, using the side of your brush just to get a bright green line like that. Now when you come to these trails, you're again going to apply it in the same sort of way, but this time just focus that green more towards the middle. So you're getting a narrower kind of arrowhead shape this time. Now down towards the base where the skull is, you need to layer across the whole thing. But when you get down towards the base here around the eyes, just stop there so that you're leaving the darker green down there towards the hilt. With the cobalt green done, the sword's looking much brighter now, and the next step is to do another highlight, this time using cyberite green. Now, I've still got my fine detail brush because the application here is going to be, well, much the same as what we've just done. So once you've got your paint ready, you're looking to do an edge highlight running all the way around the edge of the blade again, and also on the trails. So using the edge of the brush again, you're looking at a thin line just running around the edge and down the centre as well. And on the trails, as I say, you're looking to just go a little bit closer to the middle. So still a fairly wide line like that, but narrower than the previous one you've just done. Now when you get to the skull down the base here, what I do is paint around either eye, run around like that, and then follow this to the teeth on the most raised surfaces. So down the tooth like that. And using the side of the brush like this will make it really easy just to run around the nose like that. So you just need to carry on this now and do this on both sides of the blade. Once that highlight's done, you can see the sword starting to look really magical. And what I'm going to do next is carry on building up this effect. And I'm going to do this by first applying a shade, and Collier Green shade is the one I'm going to use. And the brush I've got is a large brush. Now, as you're doing this, it's very important that you don't put too much of this on. Because when you're applying it, if it does start running, you do have too much, and that way it's very easy to lose control of it. So when you put it on, keep it thin, like I'm doing here. So you can see I'm applying it towards the top, but it's not running, so that's the perfect amount. Now doing this will start to give a subtle green tint to all of that black, and it'll also help bring all these colours that you've been putting on so far together. So now the shade is dry, you can see it's really brought the colours together. The next thing we're going to do is carry on adding this green tint to the blade, this time by using Waywatcher Green. And this I'll be applying in the same way as what we've just done for the Collier Green shade. So you're looking to apply a good even coat of this glaze across the whole blade. And once again, if you're putting on so much that it starts running on its own, then you've applied too much. So keep it thin, just like I've got here. I've given the glaze plenty of time to dry, and you can see now I've got a really nice green tint across the entire sword. Now, all I've got left to do on it is to add some fine highlights just to finish it off, and I'm going to be doing two colours for this. First of all, I'm going to edge highlight with Cybrite Green, and then I'm going to edge highlight really delicately with White Scar. So for the Cybrite Green, I'm going to be using a fine detail brush, and you need to get your paint ready, and, well, this part really is all about being as neat as you can be. So let's get the paint ready. Not too much on the brush. And so, first of all, you need to do the edge highlight going all the way around the sword and down the centre, like we've been doing before. You'll see this colour is nice and bright now in comparison to the area around it. There we go. And also, on these trails, you're looking at just doing a thin line running down the most raised part of it, just down the centre of each of those, just like that. And on the skull here, it's, well, it's again, it's thin lines running around the most raised surfaces. So down the teeth, around the nose here, and around the eyes as well. And then the final stage is to add just a final highlight of White Scar just towards the tip of the sword. So not far down, just to around about there, and down the sides as well. And also on the trails, you just need a little bit in the middle towards the ends, just like that. And with the edge highlight done, the sword is complete, and now we can move on to the next stage, which is to paint the gold. Now, there are quite a few gold bits all around Nagash, so I recommend that you look at your box art to guide you through which bits to do like this. But I'm going to be focusing on Nagash's crown to show you how to do it. Now, I'm going to be using four colours here. I'm going to start with a base coat of Balthazar Gold, then I'm going to shade the whole area using Agrax Earthshade. After that, I'm going to layer over this using Gehenna's Gold, and finally, I'm going to do an edge highlight of Runefang Steel to finish it off. Now, I'm going to be using a standard brush for most of this base coat with the Balthazar Gold, but I also have a detail brush for all the finer areas, things like around the little skulls that are on his belt. And at this step, all you're really looking to do is get as even a base coat as you can over these gold areas. So on his crown, I'm just looking to paint it on all around here. And when the base coat is done, apply Agrax Earthshade over these golden areas. Next, layer these areas with Gehenna's Gold, and I'm using a detail brush to do this. I'm going to be painting most of these areas, but still leaving the darker colour showing in the deepest recesses, just like round here on the crown. Now, Gehenna's Gold is quite a thin colour, so you might find that you need to apply more than one layer to get a smooth, even coverage. And then finally, use a fine detail brush to paint Runefang Steel all around the edges of all the golden areas that you've done. So, a sharp edge highlight just around these parts. So now the gold is finished, and I just want to point out that I missed a bit just at the top here. Just beneath that bone ridge is a row of skulls, and they're all gold as well. So, well, you can see I just painted them in now, and now all the gold is finished. So I can move on to the next part, which is going to be to paint the leather. Now this appears on belts around his body, so around his waist and on the robes around the waist as well, and also on his chest, but also all the soft parts behind the joints of his armour. Now to do these parts, you only need two colours. I'm going to start with a base coat of dried bark, and then I'm going to highlight them using Gorthor Brown. So for the first stage, for base coating the dried bark, I'm going to be using a detail brush, and this step is very straightforward. You just need to get a nice even base colour on all these parts that you want to be brown. So around his chest, for example, here on this strap running down here, I'm just going to, as neatly as possible, coat this with brown. And then use a fine detail brush to apply an edge highlight of Gorthor Brown. And there it is, the leather is now done, and really there's not that much more left to do on the model. The next thing I'm going to be focusing on is painting all the books, and I'm going to begin by painting the pages of the closed books that are floating around him. So all of these are on the robe assembly. Now for this you only need three colours. I'm going to first of all base coat with Rakarth Flesh, then I'll shade the whole thing using Agrax Earthshade, and then I'm going to highlight the pages by using Pallid Witch Flesh. And the brush I'm going to use for this base coat is the standard brush, so you just need to get your Rakarth Flesh ready. And, well, I'm going to enjoy doing this part because these books have looked quite messy for a while now. All you've got to do is start base coating the pages. So you're just looking at painting around the edges, just like that. Next, apply a shade of Agrax Earthshade over the pages. And then finally, use a fine detail brush to apply some Pallid Witch Flesh, just as thin lines running along the length of the pages. And you only need to do one or two here, really, because that shows, well, it gives the impression of the lots of pages being in there. And once you've done that on all of the books, the next thing to do is to paint the book covers. Now, I'm not going to go into detail as to how to do this, because all the techniques you need to know to paint all the covers, we've already covered. So, for example, with the open book with the skin on it, that's going to be done in exactly the same way as the human flayed flesh that's on the sword scabbard. And the same is true for things like the bone trim on them, and some of them have the same style as his armour. So it's just a matter of going around all the books now, painting them in whichever way you choose to do so. So once I finish doing these pages, I'm going to go away and do that, and when we come back, I'll show you how to paint the interior of the open book. So there we go. Now I've done all the book covers, and you can see what I mean. The ones around the front here I've done in the same sort of skin tone as I did with the sword scabbard earlier. And this one around here, I've left the cover of that black, but I've done the trim in the same way as the bone that we did around his armour. So all the techniques for doing these we've covered already, but when you get to this stage, you'll need to paint the chains that go around some of these. Now for this, you're only going to need three colours. I'm going to start out with a base coat of lead belcher, then I'll shade them using Norn oil, then finally I'm going to add a highlight of runefang steel. So starting with the lead belcher, I'm going to be using my standard brush for this. And, well, this step is all about just getting a good base coat along all the chains and the padlocks as well whenever they appear. So for this book around here on the front, you're just looking to get that good base coat all across these chains, just being careful because of the book beneath them. Next, I'm going to apply Norn oil using a detail brush this time, and just being careful that I'm not putting on too much so that I don't lose control of it. And finally, use your fine detail brush to highlight with runefang steel. So you just need to paint little lines on the links like I'm doing here, and also around the padlock, you just need to go around the edges. And with the chains done, the books are now complete. And now I'm going to move on to showing you how to paint the interior of the open book. And this I'm going to be doing in a very similar way to how I did the spirits originally, except I'm going to go a bit whiter, and that's because I want it to look like the pages are glowing. Now the first colour you need for this is Celestra Grey, and I'm going to be applying this using my standard brush. And this first coat is, well, it's a base coat like we did originally. As before, you may find you need to do more than one layer to get a solid colour, but here's the book. And also, I've painted the cover of this one, which I did at the same time as the other books, in the same kind of way. So for the pages, you're just looking for that base coat across all of them. And some of them are peeling open, so you will need to poke your brush down in between them around there. Be careful not to get on the trim of the book, and also around here, where the spirit is, you can actually paint behind him. So make sure you get all of that area around there as well. Once the base coat's finished, the next thing to do is to layer the pages, this time using Orthuan Grey. Now having the base coat of Celestra Grey down first of all means we're going to get a very strong colour very quickly, so this is perfect for what we need now. I'm using the same brush to apply it, so it's my standard brush again, and once again I'm looking to just get as even a coat as I can across the whole of the pages. So you may need to apply more than one coat, but you see doing this will bring it up to an almost white very quickly. Once you finish the layer, the next thing to do is to begin adding the green glow to the book. And the first colour for this is Nihilac Oxide, which I'm still going to be applying using my standard brush. And this you want to be painting over, well, all the pages once again, really. So, towards the top, this is the only time when one of your colours, when you're doing the pages, should reach the very edge, the border of the book. So just up to about there to bring the glow onto the edge slightly. And also, whilst you're doing this, just let it run into the recesses like I'm doing around here. But don't forget to do around the back in here as well. You need to make sure you cover all the pages with this. Once the Nihilac Oxide is completely dry, there's just a few more colours to go to finish off the pages. Now the first of these will be Orthuan Grey again to neaten them up as a layer. Then I'm going to be doing an edge highlight with White Scar. And then finally I'm going to add some Waywatcher Green just to build the ethereal green glow. So for the Orthuan Grey, I'm going to be using a detail brush this time, and I'm just going to be taking a bit more care as to how I apply it so that I'm leaving the Nihilac Oxide in the deeper areas. So on the face around here, for example, I'm going to be painting around his head there, but when I get to these kind of stretched lines that are coming out the pages, I'm going to be painting either of those and then pick up the colour again on this side here. So I'm leaving that Nihilac Oxide in the recess just like that. So you just need to do this around the whole book now across all these pages. And then use your fine detail brush to apply an edge highlight all the way around the pages, so all down the sides along here, and also on the most prominent details on the spirit's face. So things like its brow just along here, around the eyes and around the nose, down the arm, that kind of thing. And then finally, add some Weight Watcher Green into the deepest recesses using your fine detail brush. And as you can see, this adds just a nice spot of colour to this ghostly effect. And there we go, the book is now finished. But if you want, you can add some script to the inside of it, like the one in the box. And if you want to do that, then this is how you do it. You need dried bark and a fine detail brush, and this is all about brush control. So when you get your paint on your palette, thin it down with some water, water's just fine for this technique, and make sure that you don't have much paint on your brush and that you get your brush to a nice fine tip. So see, I'm thinning it down a little bit more than usual, getting rid of all the excess and bringing the bristles to a point like that. So what you need to do is brace your hands as steadily as possible and just start painting a wiggly line roughly running across the page of the book like that. And every now and then you can flick your brush up and down to sort of make the impression of elaborate calligraphy as you're going along. Like that, and there you go. So you just need to keep on doing this in even lines, just running across the book. Now when you get onto the other page, when you get up to the spirit, just stop as you get close to it. So you're painting along, then stopping just as it starts emerging from the page. And once you've done this, well, the book is complete. And with that, all the books are now complete. And now there's just one more thing left to paint in the entire model, and that's Nagash's eyes. Now for doing this, there's three stages. First of all, I'm going to pick them out using White Scar. Then I'm going to glaze over them using Waywatcher Green. And then finally, I'm going to mix Waywatcher Green with Larvae Medium and a one-to-one mix. And that's just to create a glow effect around the eye sockets. So for the White Scar, the brush you need is a fine detail brush. And well, this once again is all about brush control. So make sure you thin your paint down just a little bit and get a really fine tip on your brush. So if I just get it ready there, about that's fine. And what you're looking to do here is keep your hands as steady as possible and just put a dot on the eyes in there in the socket. So you just need to put your brush in until you get to the eye itself and just put a dot in it just in there. So you just need to do this now on both eyes and get that white as bright as you can. Next, use your fine detail brush to paint Waywatcher Green into the eye socket there. Just let it run down to the bottom. And then finally, mix Waywatcher Green and Larvae Medium to one-to-one mix and use your fine detail brush just to paint some of this onto the cheekbones there. This is just to create that glowing effect from the eye sockets. And once you've done that, you're done. So now we're almost at the stage that I'm most looking forward to, of the final assembly. But unusually, before we do that, I'm actually going to base the robe assembly. And that's because if I were to glue Nagash's body in there especially, you can see it'd be quite difficult for me to start getting this tool in here to do the base. So I'm going to do that first, and then I'll come back and show you how to do the final assembly. And of course, as I always recommend, base this miniature in the same way as the rest of your army. Okay, so once the base is done, we're ready to do the final assembly. And I'm going to begin with the body, and I recommend you do the same. Now, this is where that super glue came in useful earlier on when we glued these parts to these flying stands, because this should quite easily break away now, because it's going to be quite a brittle join. There we go. Right, now, I'm going to begin by gluing this into the robes, and I'm going to be applying some glue just around here. I don't need to worry about cleaning up this component, because that stand was glued inside Nagash, so the glue is not going to get in the way of any of these joins here, so you can just put a little bit of glue on. Don't need very much because this is quite a secure fit as it is. And then this is where all that practice is going to come in useful, because you just need to jostle him into the right kind of position early on. So just fits in there, and you keep gently pushing him until you feel resistance. Then you've just got to get a good grip and just force him into position like that. And there we go, he's now in the robes. So I'm going to carry on now gluing on all the other components onto this assembly here. And some of these other parts you will need to clean up before you actually stick them into position. So I recommend you dry fit them before you glue them. But just a case now of working through all the parts one at a time, and then you're finished. And there we go. Now Nagash is fully built, fully painted. He is complete. Now this miniature is a challenge, but he's a real centerpiece because of that, and he's a lot of fun to paint too. I just know you're going to have fun painting yours. Now when you're doing this stage in Nagash, and I know I always say it, but just be as neat as you possibly can. The neater you are, the better the final result's going to be. Now once you've painted all the details on him and you get to putting together the final assembly, remember to do the base before you stick anything. It's much easier to do it that way round when Nagash's body isn't in the way. Now finally, when you are doing that final assembly, use super glue thin. That will give you a real strong join very quickly. Now this video series has been a lot of fun to make. It's been a real challenge too. I hope you guys have enjoyed it and learned something, and I really hope you have fun painting your Nagash. I'll see you next time for some more tutorials.